You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.
What a great occasion it is at the home of Sherman Mack here in Albany, awaiting the arrival of the Attorney General, who is considered to be the front runner for governor of Louisiana, Jeff Landry. One of those waiting is an attorney, Glenn Westmoreland, also a school board member, also in the law firm with Sherman Mack. So what do you expect to hear from the AG?
Well, I think he's going to continue what he has done in the Attorney General's office, but on a much larger scale of leading our state. Conservative values, we'll hear a lot about that, and managing the money of the state.
Just recently, he won a big victory in federal court on freedom of speech. That was at the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals, so it'll have national ramifications in terms of the government using social media to enforce censorship.
Yeah, that's true. You know, there's a big wave on social media. You know, there are several lawsuits involved. You know, I'm a member of the school board in Tangipahoa, and we just passed a resolution to allow attorneys to pursue that on behalf of the school board with all the mental health issues that social media causes in our school. So we're going to try to recoup some of our expenses based on that.
For example, when you hear of a school shooting, which does not involve us here, but it's certainly been in the news from Port Allen, from Greensburg, and other places, you can all trace it back to arguments between these kids on social media. The problem is these days they may be heavily armed.
Oh yeah, man, it makes me cringe every time I see that on the news. And now this is only a few miles, this shooting today is only a few miles from our parish line. And, you know, some people were upset last week when we announced that when you go to a football game, you're going to have to be frisked with a wand, and you're going to have to bring clear bags into the stadium. And please, people, understand it's for your and your family and my family's safety when we do that.
Well, speaking of the school board, we had a pretty smooth opening of school.
Yes, we did. Everything went well. There was one little smoke that happened at Hammond Eastside y'all may have heard about. We got a new principal there, you know, Miss Biao, and for her grand opening, one of the light fixtures decided to want to smoke. So we had to have people come out there and they got it fixed and all, but she's like, what a grand opening for me.
You know, there are a lot of school districts that wish that was their worst problem at the opening of school.
Oh, I know. We're definitely on the right track. You know, we got stiff competition now. We are getting people from neighboring parishes to come to our parish, and we're able to give them incentives to do that. And it's only for the betterment of our children, because, you know, at the end of the day, Ken, that's what it's all about, is educating our children.
Well, I hear that uniforms will come back for an item of debate over skirts, and the problem is that whatever the hem length is that you set in the dress code, there's always going to be a kid or two or three that don't comply.
That's true, and you know, I hate having that subject, but you know, that's part of my job. And I'll just state for the record, I am always in favor of skirts. I'm not in favor of short skirts. And I think the issue going back is, you know, how are we gonna determine what's appropriate and not? I know there's some scuttlebutt and talk about, well, at the end of your fingertips, as long as it's to the end of your fingertips, then it would be acceptable. So we're going to hear, and not only are we going to debate it ourselves, but we welcome comments from parents and administrators, because, I mean, we don't want all day administrators to be having to worry about this policy. But on the other hand, we have to have a policy that's enforced.
What else are you working on the school board?
Well, you know, I think we are now starting to bid out a lot of the second phase jobs where, you know, we're getting a two-story building at Ponchatoula and some other schools. So that's going to be exciting. I know we just had a lot of ribbon cutting from the first phase. So now we're moving into the second phase. I think the architects, we're deciding which architects gets to draw the plans. And so you'll see a lot more construction coming. And we always have an eye out for what additional needs we may need as facilities. Not only do we need to improve the existing ones, but like out in the Bedico area and Ponchatoula area, they're so big, eventually one day we're going to have to answer that question of what we're going to do with the students.
Right. I mean, you look at the geography and the preponderance of the South End that is growing. I mean, it's amazing, really. One subdivision can have 1,000, 2,000 children, 3,000 children. That's enough for a new school.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. With, you know, what's Ponchatoula High School has 2,200 students by itself. And even when we put these new classrooms, I think it's 18 new classrooms, they will be full, too. So, I mean, long term, we have to decide what we're going to do with that situation.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, that's it, Ken. One thing I would like to say is our sales tax has been doing excellent. It's went through a little bump a couple months ago, but it's leveling off now and it's still doing good. And if we continue to do good with the sales tax and the additional half cent that was passed 2 years ago, we will be giving our employees more incentives and more money.
Drive with confidence. From routine service to complete engine repairs, you can trust the pros at A1 Quick Oil to get you back on the road safely. Drop it off or sit and wait in customer-friendly comfort. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.